Okay, so the first thing for us to check here is the application root directory, the folder that sits at the very top level of our FDME folder structure. And we can find out that by selecting the Setup tab here in the web interface, and then selecting the System Settings link. And you'll see here that this application root folder setting has already been determined in this environment. So we have a folder just called FDME eApps that sits beneath the C drive. Further to this, it would help to know the target application folders that are used for each of the target applications we have registered. So again, in this environment, if we look at those target applications, you can see that I have a single HFM application called KT Demo registered, and I've also got an S-based application called Calc Small OTL. Each of these applications has their own root directory as well, and those can be found by going to the Application Settings link here. From this screen, you can choose your target application using the dropdown, and then you'll see their own application root folder property here. Now, if these application root folder properties are blank, then you'll find that they're just using the top level application root folder as per the system settings screen. So as you can see, we have got a specific subfolder referenced here, and if we check the second target application, this also has its own application folder too. Using these details, I can now explore the folder structure to find the scripts folders that we saw on the slide a moment ago. So if I open a file browser here, and I go to my top level C drive, then the FDME eApps folder sits here. This is our application root folder. We then have our target application root folders listed here, and we can open those up. And then as shown on the slide before, we have an inbox and an outbox for storing our standard files. But then we also have a data folder. This then contains a scripts folder with subdirectories here for each of the various script types, other than mapping. And this then lists a series of subfolders, one for each of the script types that we can store here. Opening these folders up, you could then review any existing scripts that were available for the target application in question. And so we have, for example, here an event script. I could then open this up in an external editor, which would allow me to begin work on the script file itself. Now, later on in the course, we will be examining scripts such as this in more detail. We'll explore the Jython syntax that's used, and the approaches that can be adopted to write more complex scripts. For the moment though, hopefully this gives you a good idea for where scripts are stored in the underlying folder structure, and therefore how you might go about accessing them in order to maintain them using an external editor.